his miracle reside the Quran.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back to another live edition of Correct Your Recitation. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, all praises due to Allah. We'll begin a very interesting story beginning from ayah number 10, the story of Prophet David and his son Prophet Suleiman, followed by the story of Saba. So that will cover from ayah number 10 through ayah number 19, inshallah. Without any further ado, let's listen attentively to the beautiful recitation of both guests. Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, please go ahead.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ولقد آتينا داود منا فضلا يا جبال أوبي معه والطير وألنا له الحديد أن اعمل سابغات وقدر في السرد واعملوا صالحا إني بما تعملون بصير ولسليمان الريح غدوها شهر ورواحها شهر وأسلنا له عين القطر ومن الجن من يعمل بين يديه بإذن ربه ومن يزغ منهم عن أمرنا نذقه من عذاب السعير يعملون له ما يشاء من محاريب وتماثيل وجفان كالجواب يعملون له ما يشاء من محاريب وتماثيل وجفان كالجواب وقدور الراسيات وتماثيل وجفان كالجواب وقدور الراسيات اعملوا آل داود شكرا وقليل من عبادي الشكور فلما قضينا عليه الموت ما دلهم على موته إلا دابة الأرض ما دلهم على موته إلا دابة الأرض تأكل من سأته فلما خر تبينت الجن أن لو كانوا يعلمون الغيب ما لبثوا في العذاب المهين لقد كان لسبأ في مسكنهم آية آية جنتان عن يمين وشمال كلوا من رزق ربكم كلوا من رزق ربكم واشكروا له بلدة طيبة ورب غفور فأعرضوا فأرسلنا عليهم سيل العرم وبدلناهم بجنتيهم جنتان جنتين عن يمين وشمال وبدلناهم بجنتيهم جنتين ذواتي أكل خمط وأثل وشيء من سدر قليل ذلك جزيناهم بما كفروا ذلك جزيناهم بما كفروا وهل نجازي إلا الكفور وجعلنا بينهم وبين القرى التي باركنا فيها قرى ظاهرة وقدرنا فيها السير وقدرنا فيها السير سيروا فيها ليالي وأياما آمنين
فقالوا ربنا
سيروا فيها ليالي وأياما آمنين فقالوا ربنا باعد بين أسفارنا وظلموا أنفسهم وظلموا أنفسهم فجعلناهم أحاديث ومزقناهم كل ممزق إن في ذلك لآيات ذلك لآيات لكل صبار شكور.
ما شاء الله بارك الله فيكما. May Allah bless you both. So my dear viewers, in Surah Saba, the Almighty Allah, in today's segment, we heard that he has narrated and revealed to his Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about Prophet David and about Prophet Suleiman. And by the way, Allah the Almighty also spoke about Prophet Suleiman in other chapters and how he made the jinn subservient to him, such as in Surah Sad, which is a few surahs after Surah Saba. Surah Sad is chapter number 38. And then the Almighty Allah spoke about Saba, which is a tribe lived in a place called Ma'rib in Yemen. Inshallah, we'll get to learn about all of that. And that's why the surah, Surah Saba, is named after the tribe or the people of Saba and their ayah, their great ayah, their great sign, and what happened to them. Let's begin with Prophet David or Dawood alayhi salam. Wait a minute, you said alayhi salam? Yes. All the prophets of Allah, may peace be upon them. And only the Muslim Ummah do so. Only the Muslims believe in Allah and in all His messengers. لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا وفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. So only those who believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and in the oneness of Allah, they believe in all the messengers from Adam till Muhammad, peace be upon him. And whenever the name of any prophet is mentioned, we should say alayhi salam. So Dawood or David alayhi salam, Allah the Almighty said in ayah number 10 of Surah Saba, chapter number 34, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ مِنَّا فَضْلًا. لَقَدْ itself in Arabic, it benefits التحقيق, يعني certainly, no doubt. And the lamb is for an oath. So the Almighty Allah is confirming a couple times, indeed, most certainly, Dawood, Prophet David, alayhi salam, peace be upon him, have received from Allah great bounties, fadlan. And this fadl, or Allah's bounties which he bestowed upon David, peace be upon him, were not only related to the hereafter, yani choosing him to be a prophet, but also related to the worldly life, because Dawood alayhi salam was a king. And he had the possession of a lot of things, and Allah made him in control of a lot of things, and made the iron in his hand like mud, like clay, like sponge. أَلَنَّا لَهُ الْحَدِيدِ. And he taught him how to make armors. And Allah the Almighty gave him a lot of power. So this is from among the bounties or al-fadl of Allah, which he said, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ مِنَّا فَضْلًا. Among Allah's fadl, among Allah's bounties upon David, peace be upon him, who was the very first in the history of mankind to combine between the prophethood and the kingship. So he was both a prophet and a king. And we know that the messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was offered to be a king and a messenger, or a poor and a messenger. He said, I would rather be a poor and messenger. In the case of Dawood alayhi salam, he was the first. Then afterward, his son Suleiman also became a prophet, and he inherited the kingship and he became a king as well. Among al-fadl, or Allah's bounties upon Dawood alayhi salam, is the melodious voice whenever he would chant at-tasbih and the words of praises. Dawood alayhi salam was given the most melodious voice ever. And he used that in praising the Almighty Allah, in making tasbih, making tahmid, takbir, tahleel, praising the Almighty Allah. So as a result, and because of his fascinating voice, the mountains, the birds, the animals, and the insects would pause and listen attentively to his melodious voices in praises, and then they will join him. And Allah the Almighty spoke particularly about al-jibal wal-tayr. So he said, ya jibalu, o mountains. But the mountains are lifeless objects, are inanimates. Yeah? To you, to me. But before Allah the Almighty, He said by the end of Surah Al-Ahzab, which we studied together, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ So He addressed them with the amana, with takalif, and they refused. فَأَبَيْنَا أَن يَحْمِلْنَهَا And Almighty Allah says in another ayah, لَوْ أَنزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَى جَبَلٍ لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِعًا مُتَصَدِّعًا مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ So when you look around you and you think that these inanimates and these lifeless objects, they do not comprehend, they don't know what is going on, you're gravely mistaken. Because the Almighty Allah said in Surah Al-Isra, وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ So He negated the possibility of having any creation, any creature, even those whom we call jamadat, lifeless objects. But they do glorify the praise of Allah. But you, me, Sheikh Abdul Khaliq with his melodious voice, we don't know what they say. Not even the companions. Up until the Prophet ﷺ put some papers in his hand, then in Abu Bakr's hand, then in Umar's hand, and they were able to hear them making tasbih. So because of the melodious voice and the beautiful sound of Dawood alayhi salam, Ya jibalu awwibi ma'ahu wat-tayr. So Allah gave two examples, one of the mountains and one of the birds, the life objects, the animals, whom whenever the flocks of birds migrating, they hear the praises of Sulaiman, of David, peace be upon him, they pause. The fish in the sea, they pause. They listen to David's tasbih and praises, and furthermore, they join him in glorifying the praises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once heard one of the Sahaba was reciting Quran, and he did not inform him. He just kept on listening to him, and after he finished, he said, by the way, I enjoyed your citation, and indeed, you've been given mizmaran min mazamiri Dawood. Dawood alayhi salam, in Arabic, we have maqamat. So if Sheikh Abdul Khaliq or Sheikh Ahmed was reciting in the beginning, they have different levels, different tones. In order for you not to get bored, you feel like, this is amazing, this is pretty cool. You know, they take you from one level to another. So Mazamiru Dawood, the different tones, like music, whenever he was praising the Almighty Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon him this ni'mah, this fadl, and also Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, radiyallahu anhu. So he said to him, peace be upon him, indeed you've been given one of the mazamir of Dawood because you have a melodious voice in the recitation of the Quran. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered us an nataghanna bil Quran, yani to make your voices beautiful whenever you recite Quran. That can never be achieved unless if you study tajweed. And you know when and where to make ghunna and how long. And it is not permissible to make the ghunna three counts or to prolong the mad more than it deserves in order to purify your voice. No, there are limits. And that's why we say about tajweed, huh? إعطاء كل حق حرف حقه ومستحقه. To give every word, every phrase, every verse, no, every letter. It's right and its due characteristics. Beautiful. وَأَلَنَّا لَهُ الْحَدِيدِ And among the bounties of the dunya that Allah the Almighty have made the hadid pliable, soft, marin. So as you hold that ball and you squeeze it in order to strengthen your fingers, your muscles, your joints, for David alayhi salam, holding metals and bending them, bending irons and shaping them was a piece of cake. وَأَلَنَّا لَهُ الْحَدِيدِ Allah has made iron easy for him to shape without having to heat it up as the forestsmith or the blacksmith do. You don't have to do that. He didn't have to do that. What is the purpose? He taught him a job. He taught him صَنْعَة صَنْعَةَ لَبُوسٍ لَكُمْ So David alayhi salam, also besides being a king besides being a prophet, used to earn and eat from his own lawful earning. وَإِنَّ نَبِيَ اللَّهِ دَاوُودْ كَانَ يَأْكُلُ مِنْ عَمَلِ يَدِهِ. The Prophet ﷺ said, there is no better food any person can eat, better than the food that he purchased out of his own lawful earning. And he gave an example, Prophet David ﷺ, being a king, being a prophet, but he used to manufacture the armors, he used to sell them, and he used to buy food for himself and his family out of his own lawful earning. أَنِعْمَلْ سَابِغَاتْ. The word سَابِغْ, يعني it covers the entire body. It covers up to the toes, it covers up to the ankles. Okay, سَابِغْ. ثَوْبٌ سَابِغْ, long enough to cover the entire body. اعمل سابغات, plural of سابغ, which means manufacture and make armors. I think we can share with you how the armors that David عليه السلام used to do. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَدِّرْ فِي السَّرْدِ. So Allah the Almighty taught him how to make rings, and how to make the rings all even. And then there is a little opening in each ring. So he will insert it in another ring. As you see, there is an image on the screen. Okay? It looks like a thawb, but it's not a thawb. This is an armor made of rings, inside rings. And the whole armor covering the entire body. So if somebody is hit with an arrow or with a sword, it will protect him. It will take the head and it will not penetrate to his body. So that is the meaning of وَقَدِّرْ فِي السَّرْدِ. And also make those links and circles, calculate them accurately so that you insert them inside each other. And this is how he used to make سابغات, armors from head to toe. وَأَعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا. Besides working to earn your living, you, your family, and your people, all of you should work righteous. Do righteous good deeds to benefit you in the hereafter. إِنِّي بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. Because indeed I'm fully seeing and fully aware of what you do, whether in public or in private. So again, to recap what Allah the Almighty have mentioned of his bounties upon David, peace be upon him, in ayah number 10 and ayah number 11. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ مِنَّا فَضْلًا يَا جِبَالُ أَوِّبِي مَعَهُ وَالطَّيْرُ وَأَلَنَّا لَهُ الْحَدِيدَ أَنِعْمَلْ سَابِغَاتٍ وَقَدِّرْ فِي السَّرْدِ وَاعْمَلُوا صَالِحًا إِنِّي بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. In ayah number 12, briefly also, Allah the Almighty will shed some light on his son, David's son, Solomon, peace be upon him. And they're all among the children of Israel, and the Anbiya and the prophets of Bani Israel, the children of Yaqub alayhi salam, may peace be upon all of them. Out loud, every Muslim understand that we all love all the prophets of Bani Israel, and the prophets before Bani Israel, and the prophets after Bani Israel, including Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam. With that you become a believer. So here Allah the Almighty said about Suleiman, peace be upon him. وَلِسُلَيْمَانَ الْرِيَحَ غُدُوهَا شَهْرٌ وَرَوَاحُهَا شَهْرٌ. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَغَدْوَةٌ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَوْ رَوْحَ خَيْرٌ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَ فِيهَا. What is غَدْوَة and what is رَوْحَة? We call Salatul Fajr Salatul Ghada, isn't it? Right? What is ghada? Early morning. So al-ghadwa, when you leave for work early morning. And in the hadith, la-ghadwatun fi sabilillah, if you're listed in the army and you're going for your post in the morning and you're walking, this walking fi sabilillah to guard the borders, to defend the Muslim ummah, is better than the whole world and what it contains before Allah. Awroha, you return. So it's like shifts. Some people go in the morning and they stay up until Az-Zawal. Az-Zawal is when the sun starts moving away from its meridian. That's Zuhr time, that's right. Ar-Rawha is soon after the Zawal, you start declining and going back. So that is the meaning of وَلِسُلَيْمَانَ الرِّيحَ غُدُوُّهَا شَهْرٌ وَرَوَاحُهَا شَهْرٌ. Allah the Almighty have made the wind subservient to Sulaiman alayhi salam. And he said in Surah Sad about Arih, تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِهِ رُخَاءً حَيْثُ أَصَاب. So he says to the wind, I want you to carry Ahmad, Sheikh Ahmad, to India, because people are waiting there, they want to listen to his recitation. Sure, O Prophet of Allah. And then the wind will carry you and will go to India. How long would it take? The speed of the wind. So, for instance, from Mecca to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, where Suleiman and David were living, it's 1 month journey. No, it would only take from the morning till noon. And to return back from noon till the evening, that is the meaning of rawah. وَرُوَّهَا شَهْرٌ وَرَوَاحُهَا شَهْرٌ. يعني 1 day journey, people would cover it in 2 months. What people normally cover in 2 months, the wind would cover in less than 1 day by the leave of Allah, obeying the command of Sulaiman alayhi salam. Look what Allah the Almighty says in Surah Sad in ayah number 36. فَسَخَّرْنَا لَهُ الرِّيحَ تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِهِ رُخَاءً حَيْثُ أَصَابْ. So we subjected and we made the wind subservient to him, blowing by his command gently wherever he directed. Go here, go there. And then the following ayat will speak about how Allah made the jinn subservient to Sulaiman alayhi salam. But wait a minute. He said, وَأَسَنَّا لَهُ عَيْنَ الْقِطْرِ. Sa'il means liquid. Sa'il means liquid. Al-Qitr, the copper. Ya'ni Allah has made for him a spring, but not of water, rather a spring of liquid copper. So for his father, he has made the iron soft, so he can shape it and make the armors. And for him, he provided him with a spring of liquid copper. To do what? To make vessels, utensils, kitchenware out of the copper, which was already molten. It was in the form of liquid. وَأَسَلْنَا لَهُ عَيْنَ الْقِطْرِ. And we have made the copper molten for him. وَمِنَ الْجِنِّ مَنْ يَعْمَلُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِ. And here is an ayah number 12. Allah the Almighty says, and among the jinn, those who were working for him by the leave of his Lord. He did not subject the jinn for himself. Rather, Allah subjected them to him. So here in Surah Sad, Allah the Almighty says, وَالشَّيَاطِينَ كُلَّ بَنَّاءٍ وَغَوَّاسٍ. Satans were working for him. Some building lofty constructions, and some diving and collecting the pearls and the fish and the valuables from the bottom of the sea. وَآخَرِينَ مُقَرَّنِينَ فِي الْأَصْفَادِ. And other Satans who disobeyed are being chained. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, all of that because of the dua of Sulaiman alayhi salam. When he passed the test in ayah number 35 of Surah Sad, he said, قَالَ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَهَبْ لِي مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَابِ. My Lord, pardon me and grant me mulkan, domain and kingdom, ownership, which will not be given to anyone after me. Indeed, you are the all bestower and the all giver. وَمِنَ الْجِنِّ مَنْ يَعْمَلُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِ. Allah subjected the jinn to work for him by the leave of Allah the Almighty. وَمَنْ يَزِغْ مِنْهُمْ عَنْ أَمْرِنَا نُذِقْهُ مِنْ عَذَابِ السَّعِيرِ. And whoever deviates among them from our command, we will make him taste the punishment of the blazing fire. So the jinn did not have a choice. All the shayateen were subjected to Sulaiman alayhi salam. What do they do? يَعْمَلُونَ لَهُ مَا يَشَاءُ مِنْ مَحَارِيبَ وَتَمَاثِيلَ وَجِفَانٍ كَالْجَوَابِ وَقُدُورِ الرَّاسِيَاتِ اعْمَلُوا آلَ دَاوُودَ شُكْرًا وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. They were manufacturing for him maharib, lofty buildings, huge constructions, tamathil, images and statues of birds, of animals. وَجِفَانٍ كَالْجَوَابِ. Al-jifan means the vessels, like bowls, but not like the bowls we have the soup in or we have the food in. Bowls as big as reservoirs, so huge, because Sulaiman alayhi salam's domain was so huge. وَقُدُورِ الرَّاسِيَاتِ, and also they were making pots for him, manufacturing pots for him, which no one could move. اعملوا آل داود شكرا. Then the Almighty Allah commanded the family of David to work in gratitude. What does it mean? To utilize the blessings of Allah which He bestowed upon them and His family, to thank Him, to please Him, and not to disobey Him. And little of my servants are those who are grateful. Finally, in ayah number 14, فَلَمَّا قَضَيْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَوْتَ مَا دَلَّهُمْ عَلَى مَوْتِهِ إِلَّا دَابَّةُ الْأَرْضِ تَأْكُلُ مِنْ سَأَتَهِ. And this ayah is very interesting, because the jinn have been always deceiving human beings, making them under the impression that the jinn know the unseen and they can tell what is hidden and all of that. But when they were made subservient to Sulaiman alayhi salam, Sulaiman was watching while he was reclining on his staff, on his ken. And the jinn were working hard in building one of the constructions which Sulaiman ordered them to build. And they have been building for a whole year while Sulaiman alayhi salam have already died. He have expired. And because he was resting on his ken, he did not move. And he was mesmerized in this position, for so long. Then Allah the Almighty says, مَا دَلَّهُمْ عَلَى مَوْتِهِ إِلَّا دَابَّةُ الْأَرْضِ تَأْكُلُ مِنْ سَأَتَ. So when he decreed for Solomon death, nothing indicated to the jinn that his death, except the creature of the earth, like the termoid, eating his staff. فَلَمَّا خَرَّ, and when he fell, تَبَيَّنَتِ الْجِنُّ, it has become very clear to the jinn, أَلَّوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ الْغَيْبَ مَا لَبِثُوا فِي الْعَذَابِ الْمُهِينَ, that if they had known the unseen, they would not have remained in the humiliating torment. Because they had been working for a year while Sulaiman alayhi salam was already dead, and the power of subjecting the jinn and making them subservient to anyone was not given to anyone after Sulaiman, peace be upon him. So this is another great indication that for those who seek the help of the jinn, they're very weak, they're very vulnerable, they do not even know the unseen. And you are much stronger whenever you say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Brothers and sisters, we'll take a short break and inshallah I'll be back in a few minutes. Please stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud. Loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, my dear viewers. Our phone numbers would appear on the bottom of your screen. For anyone who would like to recite with us today from ayah number 10 through ayah number 19 of chapter number 34, Surah Saba, please dial any of the following numbers. And those who are trying to call, there are different four numbers. Do not hesitate to dial any of them. Before the break, we were talking about the final ayah, ayah number 14. فَلَمَّا قَضَيْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَوْتَ مَا دَلَّهُمْ عَلَى مَوْتِهِ إِلَّا دَابَّةُ الْأَرْضِ تَأْكُلُ مِنْ سَأَتَهِ. This is a very interesting way of proving to mankind that the jinn whom you fear, the jinn whom you seek their help, they are very vulnerable, they are very weak. As a matter of fact, the Almighty Allah stated in the Quran, إِنَّ كَيْدَ الشَّيْطَانِ كَانَ ضَعِيفًا. It is very weak, because you can defeat any Satan and you can defeat all Satans simply by seeking refuge in Allah. وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ نَزْغٌ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And look how the ending of the ayat suits the quality that is mentioned in the ayah. Indeed, Allah is the all-hearer, all-knowing. So once you say, oh Allah, khalas, He heard you. And you don't have to tell Him much, because He is fully aware, alim, He is all-knowing of what you need. And He will immediately deliver the help. إِنَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. إنه هو السميع العليم. Two different endings as you all know. One in Surah Fussilat and one in Surah Al-A'raf, chapter number 7, ayah number 200. Let's take the first caller for the day. Assalamu alaikum. Abdul Hafiz from Nigeria. Assalamu alaikum, Abdul Hafiz. Welcome to the program.
Wa alaikum assalam.
How are you,
brother? Alhamdulillahi barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, I'm doing good.
Good. Go ahead and recite from ayah number 10 of Surah Saba. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ مِنَّا فَضْلًا. Abdul Hafiz, can you hear me?
Can you?
Yeah. Which page of the Quran you have it open?
Surah Al-Maidah, Quran chapter 52.
Surah?
Chapter 56, right?
Go ahead and
Surah Al-Maidah.
Go ahead and start reciting from whichever page you have open in front of you. Bismillah.
There's no Quran with me yet, but I can recite it as much as I can.
Go ahead and recite.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Iza waqa'ati waqi'atun.
I'm listening. Go ahead. Surah Al-Waqi'ah.
Waqi'atun. What do you say?
I'm listening. Abdul Hafiz, you sound like you are in the street.
I can hear you clearly. What are you saying?
Maybe you can try again whenever you're sitting in a place where you can actually call. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We're talking about فَمَا دَلَّهُمْ عَلَى مَوْتِهِ مَا دَلَّهُمْ عَلَى مَوْتِهِ إِلَّا دَابَّةُ الْأَرْضِ تَأْكُلُ مِنْ سَأَتَهِ. So every person who assumes that the jinn know the unseen is gravely mistaken. And that is actually the statement of the jinn themselves in Surah Al-Jinn. And when they say, وَأَنَّهُ كَانَ رِجَالٌ مِّنَ الْإِنْسِ يَعُوذُونَ بِرِجَالٍ مِّنَ الْجِنِّ فَزَدُوهُمْ رَهَقًا. When some people of the humankind sought help of the jinn, so the jinn kind felt inflated and they thought, oh, cool. So the humans are asking from us. But in reality, they do not possess this power. So who gave them that feeling? Those humans who sought help from them. And they also said, وَأَنَّا لَا نَدِرِي أَشَرٌ أُرِيدَ بِمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَمْ أَرَادَ بِهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ رَشَدًا. It's like when people think that the jinn know everything, and that's why the sorcerers and the soothsayers, they consult the jinn. The jinn admitted and they said, لَا نَدْرِي, we have no clue. أَشَرٌ أُرِيدَ بِمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَمْ أَرَادَ بِهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ رَشَدًا. We don't know whether Allah the Almighty wanted to do good or bad to the humans, because this is totally unseen to us. It is only أَنَّا كُنَّا نَقْعُدُ مِنْهَا مَقَاعِدَ لِلسَّمْعَ فَمَنْ يَسْتَمِعَ الْآنَ يَجِدْ لَهُ شِهَابًا رَصَدًا. Before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent, the jinn had an access to spy on the angels who record the commandments of Allah which need to be executed over the upcoming year. So when the jinn pick up any of these informations, they share it with their allies, with their bodies of the sorcerers and the soothsayers. And then all what you need to do is share with the people one event, one single event that will take place in the future, provided it's a major event. And then they will believe in you and they will follow you even if this person is a liar. So the sorcerer, the soothsayer would say, for instance, next year, particularly on the March of June, a major thing will take place in North America. Or people who predicted the war, the Russian invasion to Ukraine, and they predicted the date and the month or whether Chelsea is going to win the final tournament, or well, people would make a big deal out of it, and this person will be all over the mainstream media and the news and headlines. This person predicted this, but it's over. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had been sent, no one have an access afterward to listen to any writing of the angels or conversation. فَمَنْ يَسْتَمِعِ الْآنَ يَجِدْ لَهُ شِهَابًا رَصَدًا. Whoever will try to listen, will try to overhear or spy on the angels, a shooting star will be anxiously waiting for him and will burn him down before he will dare to share the information with the humans. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ajmal from Denmark, assalamu alaikum and welcome to the program.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you, Shaykh?
I'm doing great, alhamdulillah, Ajmal. Thank you for asking. Go ahead. Ayah number 10. Wa laqad atayna Dawooda minna fadla.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ مِنَّا فَضْلًا يَا جِبَالُ أَوْبِي مَعَهُ وَالطَّيْرِ وَأَلَنَّا لَهُ الْحَدِيدِ. صدق الله العظيم.
Okay, بارك الله فيك. جزاك الله خيرا. Thank you, أجمل. So, since there is only a couple minutes left before the end of the program, I just wanted to share a couple things with you, inshallah, Azza Jal. Our relationship with the jinn, in the light of this ayah, in the light of the ayat of Surah Al-Jinn, should be based on the following fact. إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ قَبِيلُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُمْ. The jinn could see us, we could not see them. Unless if they appear in the images of living creatures, maybe animals, dogs, cats, snakes, or humans, it's possible, okay? Our relationship with the jinn, that we do not fear them. We know that they are among the creations of Allah, and some of them are believers, and some of them are disbelievers. If you fear the jinn, if you fear Satans, if you fear any whisper, immediately say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من شر ما أجل وأحاذر. أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق. And that's it. You're a winner by the grace of Allah. So inshallah, we will pause at the story of Prophet David and Prophet Solomon. And next time we'll begin with the story of Saba at Ma'rib in Yemen and what happened to them in details. Most likely, today's episode is going to be the last episode of Correct Your Recitation before Ramadan. And we're going to take a long break during Ramadan. And instead, every day or 6 days a week, from Saturday through Thursday, same time, 5 to 6 p.m. Every day, Saturday to Thursday, we're going to have Ask Huda Live. Same phone numbers, same media platform. And inshallah, Azza Jal will be ready to answer your questions and share with you whatever is beneficial during the blessed month of Ramadan. By that, we've come to the end and the conclusion of today's edition of Correct Your Recitation. And as I said, inshallah, we'll pause until after Ramadan. I thank my guests, Sheikh Abdul Khaliq and Sheikh Ahmed, for joining us today. And you brothers and sisters for watching us today. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran, recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. We were chosen to be part of his nation.